If you asked me the same question a year back, will West Indies be a favorite for the World Cup? I would have said probably not. Probably they don't have the side to win the World Cup. But now with the inclusion of Gale, with the inclusion of Nicholas Puron, you also have a lot of other strikers with the ball. Shai Hope, we've got Shimron Hetmeyer, Darren Bravo. These guys are serious strikers with the ball. Let's not forget Andre Russell. I mean, these guys can really hit the ball hard. They can talk the ball hard. We saw it in the warm-up game where they got up to 420 and they've gone out and openly said that we probably might be the first side to get to 500. And I tell you what, this is not bragging. They could actually go on to do that. The way they're striking the ball, the strikers that they have on the side, they just have the all-round side. I wouldn't say maybe not the all-round side, at least probably the most hard-hitting side in the entire World Cup. And I do believe that they will be a formidable side. And again, maybe top four is a possibility with the way they go about playing cricket. Well, yes, numbers don't really say that they have a good time in England. In fact, as you mentioned rightly, that 13 losses in the last 14 games in England. But having said that, do you really think West Indies cares about that? I don't think they're a side really believes in numbers, believes that they've played poorly in England. I just get a feeling that they're going to come out there, play their cricket, play their style of cricket, their brand of cricket, which is entertainment, flair, go out there, strike the ball, look to entertain the crowds. And I just get a feeling that we might see a lot of sixes, we might see a lot of big shots, we might see Gale getting hundreds, we might see Andrew Russell getting a quick fire 50-60 in the end, and Shai Hope, again, someone who's been batting exceedingly well for the Windies in recent times. Well, yes, they do have three left-arm seamers. All the three left-arm seamers are of decent quality. Maybe Mohammad Amir hasn't really got wickets in recent times. Wahab Riaz coming back after a good couple of years to play for Pakistan. To me, it's quite simple. If the ball seams around and decks around, if there is something for the faster bowlers, West Indies might struggle a wee bit. But if there isn't much on offer for the faster bowlers, I just get a feeling that the Pakistan bowlers will have a handful. West Indies' side, the power-hitting side, will or may just get the better of Pakistan.